sweater today.
Reverse retro jersey.
Yeah, I remember last year's was white. This year's is green.
Nice.
They look pretty sick.
Yeah, the old North Stars colors.
I'm going to start the song again, Rosie. I want you to hear something, okay, buddy?
Sure.
This is Bullet to Blue Sky by U2, okay? Off the Joshua Tree. So Bono went to South America, and this was in the 80s when all hell was breaking loose down there. And when he came back, they wrote this song about his trip down there and all the atrocities he saw.
Right.
He specifically wanted the snare drum to sound like a gunshot. And the guitar to sound like a plane overhead soaring over you as it was dropping bombs. Now listen to this song. And he goes through his career and his life and talks about the different songs they wrote in regards to what was happening in his life at the time they wrote it. Mm. And again, he's reading it himself,
wow,
which makes it even better. God, I love this band.
Julie.
Listen to all that. It's a soundscape, man, of madness.
Well, I'm going to just mention this real quickly. We were talking during the commercial break beforehand. The music sound bed for, among other things, the updated version of All Quiet on the Western Front, which I watched on Netflix last night, this will stay with you. And the music, the cinematography, the story, of course, the 1930 movie speaks for itself. But, I mean, the updated version, I could not recommend it more. For all sorts of reasons, just as someone once said in the show, go see it. It's worth it. And it's going to leave you shaken if you have a soul. It's just an incredible movie. And that music in that movie reminds me of this.
It's so good. That film is so good, Rose.
Oh, we were talking about that. It's just so amazing.
It's so well done.
I mean, it's the best war movie I've seen since Private Ryan. And it's literal of that. Yeah, so personal. The end of World War One. We saw did you see 1917? Did I see that with you?
Yeah, I saw it on the scale.
Yeah. Wait.
Oh. Rose, how did you know Rosie was weighing me that day? Yeah, we were. Yeah, we did. Yeah. It was super loud.
Did you know Tom Hardy was in that movie?
That's the other.
Spoiler.
That was the other
spoiler.
One.
Spoiler. That was Dunkirk.
We saw both of them together, though. Yeah.
I think we did.
Or maybe your attorney.
I saw with my attorney.
Outside.
I never saw
America.
1917. Was it good? Really good?
Yeah. It was. Yeah. This
very
was
good.
I've seen that one shot that goes viral all the time.
That you get caught up in the one shot bit. All Quiet on the Western Front is to me a better movie, a better story, a better everything about it last night through the eyes of a young German soldier was just, I don't know, mesmerizing.
It's so good. It's so well
it's
done.
So, and it's so worth. It's so important to watch.
Yeah. What'd you eat right last now? Night while you were watching it? Did you have some popcorn?
You know what? I was so riveted to it. I don't think I had dinner. I don't think I ate anything. I was just sitting there for 2.5 hours
sipping a beer
in the dark with my cats watching it.
How many cats do you have?
14. 18.
You have 18 cats.
Yeah,
you're a cat.
I'm gonna get arrested.
Why was there music playing over that?
I just have to. Willow and Stevie. That's it. They didn't. They weren't hiding. I don't know where they were.
Let me guess. As soon as you finished it, you texted my dad.
No. I didn't, actually.
Listen, Rosie. Hold on. Listen.
Okay.
Of America.
Oh.
My.
God.
Yeah, that's heavy.
Man, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good, man. Yep. They're not just writing pop songs.
Nope.
Nope.
At least they weren't back then anyway, you know?
Right.
Crazy.
All right.
It's time for Fan 5, brought to you by Builders and Remodelers.
And by the way, thank you, Builders and Remodelers. If you'd like to watch Corey live right now doing Fan 5, in person, on your television and or computer screen or phone, you stream us right now on all the social platforms. It's the Power Hour on KFAN right now.
Yeah, who doesn't want to watch this?
And
yeah,
you can see Rosie, too, reacting. Go back to Rosie for a second. Rosie, do a reaction shot. See that? Watch this now. Watch when he's sad about something. Watch. Now watch when he's... Yeah, okay, that's great. Okay.
No, Rosie, what if you are very... subtly aroused. Jeez, that wasn't so subtle.
Rosie doesn't do subtle.
Here's the problem. I've seen him make that face at my wife multiple times.
Multiple times. Oh, I almost said something.
Rosie, according to the Associated Press, Spain and France might be the site of future NFL games. Spain and France. And the logic is the 17th game gives you some neutral site opportunities. We just saw Munich. We've seen London.
Right.
I don't know. Maybe Spain and France in the near future. Your thoughts?
Well, I mean, it's the NFL is a marketing machine. We saw that firsthand. We were in London. Obviously, they've had a history there of playing in games in London for quite a while, and they have an established base there. But I think because of the worldwide popularity of our version of football, I think that the NFL knows how to market itself quite well. And so I'm sure there are plenty of fans in Spain and France out of curiosity that'll watch our and I use that term boring version of American football compared to the World Cup that they feel is, you know, the sun and rises and sets on. But it's all about marketing, and it'll make it work.
I'm sorry.
What's so funny?
Yeah, I know. I've been dying to hear
what happened.
When you were doing your whole bit there, Mark, I just watched Mark yawn, the biggest yawn I've ever seen.
It only took 15 seconds.
And it was great. And then he came back from his
nap.
And he smiled with his tooth missing. And
Marky's adorable.
And everybody on screen is making yawning faces at him. they're posting little yawning things. So if you want to watch how bored, look at this guy. If you want to watch how bored Mark Parrish is with sports, all you got to do is tune on the screen right now. Andy Blazer says, "Are you sleepy, Parrish?"
Yeah. Well, yeah, I'm always sleepy.
True. And with your hat, you look like a dwarf, a sleepy dwarf right now. Yeah.
Nice, I'll take it.
Yeah.
Well, I was Grumpy Dwarf as a nickname for a long time. So.
Yeah. That's right.
Oh. Well, let's wake Mark up. The Predators won 2-1 over the Wild. Nashville scored 2 in the first. And then scored the lone Wild goal in the third, his third goal of the year. Fleury had 23 saves. He needed at least 24. The Wild 0-for-5 on the power play. The Wild now 7-7-2. They host Jason Zucker and the Penguins tomorrow at 7.
Yeah, they played pretty well last night, just not good enough to win. Nashville really found their game. They've been struggling to find their game all year. And now we've just got to be able to find that road game that we have and bring it back home here. So we've got this for some reason this year, the Wild team has struggled at home, and what better way to snap out of that streak than with a 7-game homestand coming up here, starting with Jason Zucker and the Pittsburgh Penguins tomorrow night.
This is the opportunity we've been waiting for.
Yeah, wow. Rosie. Yeah.
Wild are still handcuffed financially by the moves they made. Are Suter and Parisi still contributing to their respective teams?
Zach's scored 2 or 3 goals already this year.
He got the game winner the other night
in OT.
Yeah.
And Suter's, he's playing a pretty big role in Dallas.
Yeah.
Why?
And we're still paying for, from the cap standpoint, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
For how many more? Is this how many more years? One, two?
60.
A couple more years.
Oh, my God.
More years.
And so, it's hurting them, right?
Well, yeah, this is, and this is the lean part. This is when you see injuries. That's when you really see the handcuffing of a salary cap and when people are up against that cap. Because you don't have reinforcements. You've got enough money to spend on your lineup, and that's it. And then you're hoping that your guys in Iowa or your draft picks can kind of fill in. So when we lose, a full, big, heavy line, like we lost Foligno, Hartman, and Greenway all at once, I mean, we just can't absorb that, especially those kind of players. What do you mean?
I mean, in terms of what it was going to, that they were not going to fulfill the end. Maybe they did feel they were going to play
it was a whole different regime.
Well, I understand.
So that's the thing, right? So
they got caught in it.
Billy's come in. Yeah, Billy's come in with his game plan.
Right.
And they are ahead of schedule. Trust me, they are ahead of schedule. Mm-hmm. And this is what we're going to kind of see. There's going to be some battles, especially when we deal with injuries in these situations, because of that, we don't have money to spend on any depth guys. This is what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to find a way to fight through these moments.
Well,
this
done.
Is the opportunity we've been waiting for.
Parrish, that was
Rosie,
dynamic.
You couldn't have said it better yourself.
Parrish, I heard every word you just said. I thought it was dynamic.
Why, thank you, Corey. I appreciate
every
it.
Single word you said.
Every single
word. But I'm not sure. I'm not 100% sure Sauce did.
Was he even listening?
Oh, yes. I hate.
Let's see if Sauce was listening. So, these are trivia questions that I write down in the segment because, look, when the segment started, Sauce had his head down. I didn't even think he was listening to the beginning. So, let's see if he was listening to this segment. All of these things took place in the last 13 minutes.
Pass. 13 minutes?
Yeah, in the last segment.
All right.
I read a question. You guys all guess whether or not Sauce was listening to the show that he is paid to participate in.
Sorry.
He's already shaking his head. You aren't listening to this segment, were you? Not really.
We'll see, Danny.
We'll see. No, Rosie.
He can fool us. She's pretty good at this.
Question number one.
During Zach's read, there was a prize that you could register to win. What was the prize that Zach said the Rubes could win?
No chance.
No.
Started the segment 13 minutes ago.
I think he's going to get it.
No.
No chance.
No.
I
nope.
do. I
no
think.
Way.
I think he's,
Rosie. You?
I think there's no chance.
Rosie,
to.
You got it.
Really? That was a long time ago. That's like a years ago.
Yes or no?
No.
Yeah. No.
Zach?
Wow.
Zach back there?
No.
No.
Okay. I'm
Rosie,
the only one who believes in you.
So Rosie, you're saying yes. Sauce, what was the prize that Zach said was possible to win?
I think he said it was a Wild Wednesday and it was wild tickets.
You know what, dude? That was a good guess, though.
So close,
though. The Wild Wednesday.
Oh,
you
were
halfway there.
Oh, yeah, it's green. Last year was white.
Yeah,
there you
are.
Yeah, remember they're
giving
away a reverse cowboy jersey.
Oh, yeah. Rosie's getting in line after the show.
Oh, for one.
Question number two.
Whose audiobook is Chris Hockey currently listening to?
He knows this one because I've talked to him about it.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he knows it. Yeah.
Oh, so in a way, it was cheating.
It's kind of cheating because I've talked to him about this for a couple of days.
Oh,
yeah.
Damn it.
Yeah,
damn it.
Sorry,
all right, so he's saying yes.
He definitely
Everybody
knows
with that then?
Well, I suppose, yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
I would have leaned no.
I would have leaned no as well.
Sauce.
Bono, and he's reading it himself.
Damn it.
Told me about it,
Off
sorry,
the air.
Sorry, yeah.
But that doesn't mean I was listening then.
Fair.
Question number three.
Right. I don't know what I was thinking.
Very true.
How many cats did Mark Rosen jokingly say he has?
Oh, I know this one.
He'll get it right.
There's an actual number of cats he has, but he joked and said he had a different number.
I'm going to say yes on this
question
one.
Question number three.
What did he have?
I'm going no because I can't remember what he joked.
Yes.
I think yes. Anybody?
Brett?
Yeah, I'm even between two numbers myself. I say no.
I say no. Zach? Right.
No.
Sauce, how many cats did Mark Rosen jokingly say that he has?
18.
Yes!
That's right!
Oh,
that's right.
How the hell did you get that?
Because then he said I have two Stevie and like French Tickler or something.
Well, whoa.
French Tickler.
French Tickler?
How did you catch that
number? He calls
number?
Him Rose.
Maybe I'm subterfuging you.
That's not a thing.
Question number four.
Mark Rosen was talking about something in a group of people, and he referenced that the sun sets and rises to what? to that group of people. The sun sets and rises to blank.
Man, I don't remember him saying that.
I don't remember, saying
I don't remember anything about that.
If you guys don't.
I don't think he will.
I'm going to say no chance.
He's talking about an entire group of people and that to them, the sun sets and rises with.
Was he defaming this group of people?
No. Anybody think he knows it?
No.
I don't know.
I don't know it either.
I don't either.
I'm sorry, Rose. Said
it. Without saying it, does anybody else know the answer?
I do, but okay, Brett you does. Can imagine why. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else know? Okay, Sauce.
I have no idea. Is it something about all quiet on the rest in front?
Nope. No. He said the soccer? Sun sets and rises to World Cup soccer.
World Cup soccer.
Yeah, you're right. He did that.
But, how do you say it? But see, here's the thing, though. When you brought it up, everyone tuned out except for Brett.
Yep. Thanks, Brett.
Thank you.
So you're blaming
That was when I was yawning, wasn't it?
The whole show checked out, and Brett only cared because he likes soccer.
He likes World Cup soccer.
Yeah.
Why I have the button bar, guys.
Exactly. Last one.
Question number 5.
Parrish and Rosen used the word handcuffed when talking about who?
He's got it.
Oh, sure.
Well, I think he can guess this.
Yeah, this.
So I'm going to say he does because I think he can guess. Yes. Yes.
I'm going to hope and say yes.
Everybody's on yes?
Yeah.
Sauce?
Say, what's the question again?
Parrish and Rosen used the word handcuffed when talking about who?
Parisian suitor?
Just checking.
All right.
Got it. All right.
How many did I get?
You got 3 out of 5.
Not bad.
That's pretty good, sir.
Hey. All right.
Paying more attention than I was.
Yeah, Rosie was, yeah. I should have got the soccer one when Brett said I'm the only one who
cares.
Yeah,
I almost gave it away. That's my fault.
I should have got that
Brett.
One.
But that might have confused you into thinking that it was Packer the Packers.
Related.
Yeah.
Right.
That's true.
Well, I'm sorry.
So what's the I think 4 is the most you've ever gotten, right? You've never gone 5 for 5, I don't think.
In what?
In that bit.
He doesn't remember what game we played.
Nope. Headlines next. Power Trip Morning Show on the Fan.
KFAN. Total traffic.
From the Quick Trip Traffic Center, I'm Chris Addison. Here's a look at the roads. Our biggest delay is in Eagan southbound 35E at 494. A crash still remains here, taking out the left 2 lanes. It looks like we have very heavy traffic levels going beyond Highway 13. Expect at least a half hour to get through there. West 694 backing up as well. Long Lake Road over to Highway 252. Westbound 94. County Road 18, our rollover crash still remains up in Monticello. That's taking out the right lane, also blocking the ramp to get to County Road 18. That's traffic on the Fan. This report is sponsored by Hamline University.
Does your child have big career dreams? They can make that dream a reality at Hamline University, ranked as the best regional university and best value regional university in Minnesota by U.S. News & World Report. Learn why at hamline.edu/first. That's hamline.edu/first.
Give 952-0RES a call today to make sure your home is as clean as possible for the holidays. Get your carpets cleaned, your air duct system cleaned, and much, much more. But remind yourself a little bit here to mention KFAN, whether it's when you call or when you go to the website, ZeroResMinnesota.com. If you ask for the KFAN special, they're going to hook you up because they love KFAN listeners. You can get 3 rooms of carpet, ZeroResified, for just $139 if you ask for the KFAN special. And they can take $50 off your air duct system cleaning package. So the carpet's going to be clean. Your air is going to be as clean as possible. Why not have the people that are in your home breathing clean air? And that's, of course, for you, your kids, your pets. So mention KFAN. They do upholstery cleaning, rug cleaning, tile cleaning, air duct system cleaning, carpet cleaning, and more. And they do it better than everybody else. That's why they have a 4.9 rating on Google with almost 15,000 reviews. So, look, Thanksgiving's almost here. Christmas is almost here. Don't delay. Make today the day you get on the calendar. Book right now by calling 952-0-RES or go to ZeroResMinnesota.com. It spells the same forward and backward. Mention KFAN.
That's the sound of a UCARE simplifier, namely me, here to help you find a great individual and family health plan. They're lower cost plans with a large network of more than 47,000 providers in Minnesota accepting UCARE. Plus, your preventive care is covered 100% in network, and most plans include online and retail convenience care at no additional cost. Not to mention help from UCARE simplifiers like me to keep things simple. It's what I do. Enroll in a UCARE plan on MinSure today at MinSure.org.
The hottest tables and friendliest dealers in Minnesota are at Canterbury Park 24/7, 365. Try your hand at 4-deck or 6-deck blackjack. Visit CanterburyPark.com and see all the current progressive table game jackpots. Come play at the park.
Helzberg Diamonds presents The Guy Who Was the MVP. Craig was proposing to his girlfriend and needed the perfect ring, so he asked her friends for some advice.
Aww.
Get yourself to Helzberg.
Yep, Craig went to Helzberg Diamonds. He learned that Helzberg's been in business for over 100 years. That means quality. And with their price match guarantee, he'd get a great deal and find the perfect ring.
Wow! It's perfect. Oh, yeah.
MVP. Most valuable proposer. Be like Craig. Find the ring of her dreams at a Helzberg Diamonds near you or at Helzberg.com.
Meat Sauce here for Window Nation and WindowNation.com. Get two free windows with every two you buy. Plus, pay nothing but no interest until 2025. Go to WindowNation.com right now. That's WindowNation.com or call 866-90-NATION, WindowNation.com.
I'll take Twin Cities fastest for 1,000. Hey!
Wait, I haven't read the answer yet.
No time to waste, little brother. I'm flash fast.
For the last time, ringing the buzzer doesn't speed up. All right, here's the answer. Pronto services your furnace within 24 hours or pays you $100 for every day you wait.
What is Pronto's same-day service guarantee?
Correct!
Oh, come on!
Tune in tomorrow. That's it. Game's over. Tell you what, just go to ProntoHeat.com.
Hey, Tennevee here for Underdog Fantasy. It's the easiest place to play fantasy football. It's also the fastest-growing fantasy app in the industry. One thing I love about Underdog Fantasy, you can play any night, whether it's Sunday night, Monday night, Thursday night, Tuesday night, because not only do they have football games on Underdog Fantasy, but you can do NHL, NBA, PGA is underway, all that available at Underdog Fantasy. You can do drafts, or you can do what I love to do, that would be the pick'em game, where you pick whether your favorite players will have a higher or lower stat total in this week's game for a chance to win big. You can win up to 20 times your money in a single game. You just have to pick between 2 and 5 players to build a pick'em entry. Sign up today with the promo code KFAN and get your first deposit doubled up to $100. Visit UnderdogFantasy.com or find them in the App Store. Don't forget to register with my promo code KFAN to get your first deposit doubled up to $100. Must be 18 plus and present in a state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play, call 1-800-522-4700 or visit www.ncpgambling.org. That's Underdog Fantasy. Use my code KFAN.
Smart Start MN, your ignition interlock specialists.
From the Evans Transportation Weather Center.
This report is sponsored by InvisibleFence.com.
Fan forecast.
Snow and then cloudy skies today. High of 32, drop it down to 18 tonight.
It's Invisible Fence Brand's mission to help keep pets secure at home. And their exclusive Boundary Plus technology does just that. As part of their Black Friday sale, get $300 off your system through November 30th. Schedule your free consultation at InvisibleFence.com. That's InvisibleFence.com.
The Golden Gopher football team hosts Iowa Saturday on the radio home of Gopher football. FM 100.3, KFAN, The Fan.
Touchdown, untouched!
Duh.
Hey, Rosie.
Yes, my love.
I love you, buddy.
Yes.
And I'm sorry if you hate this, because I know some people do. But can I tell you another story?
I love your stories.
So this song here, which
yeah,
is
I love
one
this.
A great song, right? Oh. Where the Streets Have No Name.
Incredible.
Yes.
So Bono was on a trip. Same thing. He was on a trip. And he came up with the title and the idea for Where the Streets Have No Name. Meanwhile, without him knowing, back home, Bono is writing this song musically.
No.
You mean The Edge.
Edge.
I'm sorry, Edge. The Edge. Oh, my apologies. Okay. Yeah, that's what I meant. And so they get back together, and Bono says, I have these lyrics, and The Edge says, I have this song.
Wow.
And it becomes Where the Streets Have No Name. It gives me chills to think about that. You know, I mean, it's like...
Iconic song.
Yeah, just great. Fantastic. Oh, so good. Really interesting, too, guys, because there's so much about that band that... The band almost didn't happen specifically because of a specific Christian sect that they were all members of when they were young.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, no, I'm not kidding you. And they all kind of looked at each other when they were highly involved in this version of the Christian church and kind of looked at each other and said, are we wasting our time being in a band? And they almost quit. In fact, they went to their manager after their first record and said, we're going to quit. We're not going on tour. And the manager was like, oh, that's great. So you're saying God wants you to break the contract that you signed with and that's why they didn't break up. And then they became U2.
Yeah.
It's a smart manager.
Yeah, I'm saying,
yes. Is that right?
Play
no.
The God
well
card.
Was played.
That a cove?
No, dude, for real. I mean, the manager saved the band at that moment.
Wow.
Yeah.
Where would you rank U2 among your favorite or the best? Not saying your favorite, but the best, maybe with longevity.
Right.
Hits.
And
impact.
I mean, come on, of their generation, there aren't many bands that are bigger.
No.
Of their generation. And I must admit, Rose, when I listen to a book or even if I watch a documentary about a band, they become my favorite band for a little while. I can't help it. I'm easily I'm manipulated like that.
Let's come back to U2.
But when it comes to U2, though, I have to believe that on almost anybody's list,
it has to be.
They have to be top three of their generation, right? I mean, from the time they released Waku Away, Waku Away, Waku Away, Waku, I Will Follow, which was on their first record, to today, almost every record they've had has had a giant hit, and some of them five or six different hits, right?
And I think the only time people were down on U2 is when that album was downloaded on everybody's phone. That's the only bad press.
I can't wait to get to that part.
Pissed off everybody.
And listen,
even U2 fans. Mm-hmm.
Listen, I can't wait because the very first thing he talks about in the book, he mentions that and he says, we'll get to that later. Giant mistake.
Oh boy.
He actually knows. He knows that was a giant mistake. I think he called it forcing his music on people.
Yeah.
Which is exactly how people took it.
Yeah, exactly right. Off my computer.
Dude, he's really off my phone. I think he's really honest. Like he said, he can't watch the 1985 Live Aid concert because he's, I think in his exact words, he keeps wondering what was on my head because his haircut was so bad. You know, I mean, he's really honest in the book. I'm really enjoying it very much.
Does he address the South Park episode at any point?
I'm sure he will. I'm only to the Unforgettable Fire, Joshua Tree right now. So.
Rosie, there's a bit on South Park, and it's a great episode. Where Randy Marsh is trying to break the record for the largest bowel movement of all time.
Was Burt Blyleven not there?
And at the end of the episode, this is a spoiler, he realizes that Bono doesn't have the record.
Mm.
Bono is the record. So they spend an entire episode setting up that joke that just Bono's a giant piece of crap.
Yeah, that's brilliant.
That's the South Interesting. Park. Of course.
I would almost bet that he laughs at it. But you know, from the tone of the book so far, third of the way through, I'd almost bet that he thinks it's funny. Because I think he understands that he's full of S. You know what I mean? Like he, at one point, especially in the 80s, he became so full of himself. And it's hard not to because you're 20 years old and everybody thinks you're God.
I always have so many music questions for you. Like, what's the one band you wish you could have seen live that you never saw live perform live?
Nirvana.
Yeah.
Really? Okay.
That is a great answer, Corey.
Bob Marley would have been sweet.
Mine would be Queen, probably.
That's a great answer, too.
They had to have been here.
A number of times, right?
Dude, listen, the man.
I don't know how I missed that.
Check this out. The man who's the head of Viking Security right now.
Yeah.
Was telling me a story just this past weekend when he was a young man. He was working security at the St. Paul's Civic Center.
Yeah, the Civic Center. Yeah, before. Okay. Where Springsteen performed 100,000 times. And
this was before he was a police officer. He was just a kid working security. And his boss came over, just picked him out of the crowd and said, you, come with me. And he had to guard the backstage area for Queen when they were playing a show. And he said
70-something, right?
1980, September 14th.
80? There you go, 1980. Wow. Thank you very much. So he said he's just standing there, and they start talking to him, and they're really nice to him. And he said, I'll be honest with you, I had no idea how big a deal they were. I had no clue.
Right.
And then they invite him to stand on stage behind the drummer and watch the entire concert.
Oh, come on.
Yeah. What a story, right?
That's the current security?
Yeah, yeah. He's the head of security.
I know you're talking about.
Yeah. Great guy.
I got to ask him about that.
Great guy. Incredible story, man. So anyway, speaking of concerts, by the way, I just saw this, so maybe you guys already saw it, but Pink coming to Target Field on August 10th.
Oh, is that right?
Listen to this. What a great lineup. Pink is the headliner, Brandi Carlile, and Pat Benatar.
I'm in.
How about that?
At Target Field,
and that would be August 10th. Man, if it's a nice day, there's just...
Well, there are three home runs the Twins won't be hitting.
Why would I say that? I'm a baseball guy.
I like the Twins.
You love baseball.
They were minding their own business.
It's called Tough Love is what it's called.
Somebody had to say, Rosie. That's a great concert.
That would be fun, wouldn't it?
Yeah. So Pink during the Super Bowl here. She was at the Armory.
I wish I had seen that concert.
That was sweet.
Yeah.
I heard it was sweet. Yeah.
Yeah. Boy, I wonder if that'll make headlines today.
It probably will.
Who's it brought to you by their...
Time now for headlines. Presented by Paul Bunyan Plumbing and Drain.
Who's Paul Bunyan?
What was that?
Who's Paul Bunyan?
That's my grandpa.
Oh. Hey, speaking of music, are you going to Download Festival next year?
No.
With Andy? Why not?
Why? I want to really bad, but I already have a gig booked that week.
What is wrong with you?
June 8th through the 11th? You can't unbook?
No, I can't. I have 8 people in the band.
Can I speak for my client over there?
Which one?
You.
Okay.
He booked that because he thought he'd be dead by then.
Well, speaking of that,
I'm not there yet.
I keep mentioning this to John Kreisel. The two of you, like this week, should find a weekend in April or May for the Charge Challenge just to pencil out, because you two have the schedule that gets booked the farthest
Great
out.
Point. Yep.
So you guys got to lock one in and say.
So we're allowed to pick the dates?
Well, we all have to pick. I'm saying we have to work backwards from the two of you. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because everybody's got to do it on the same weekend.
I see what you're saying.
So we'll start with Kreisel and hockey and work backwards. And then if.
But what if I win?
Well, then that's still the weekend. You know what I'm saying?
The weekend is finally
here. You guys pick a weekend. We'll clear it. All of us are locked in.
Okay.
You don't book a gig. He doesn't book a speech. Then if you find a way to pass the ghost, you can go book a gig.
Okay, I'll take care of it. Sarah, take care of that.
Yeah, talk to Kreisel, Sarah, and make sure we can find a weekend here.
Yep,
done. Hey, on our production meeting.
The ghost. Hey,
Hawk, check the oxes on the board.
The what?
Any mics not in ox?
The oxes?
Oh, yours is not in ox.
Hmm.
Nobody could hear Zach, which is probably the best show they've ever done.
It's probably
what is going on with the show
today? I think
Abbott
comes in here
so good
and presses that button.
Anyway, the only reason I ask is I love this band, but I wouldn't have gone overseas to see them. Download Fest next year. I'm sure Andy will be there. Your good friend Andy.
Yeah.
The three headliners: Bring Me the Horizon, Metallica, who I've never seen. They would be on my short list of bands that I wish I would have seen.
Metallica.
And Slipknot, but Evanescence, Architects, Disturbed. And Pendulum.
I know. Can you believe it? I didn't even know they were still together, to be honest with you.
I didn't either.
They were apart for a handful of years. Pendulum's one of my favorite bands. They're freaking awesome.
Man, I'm so glad you brought that up. I've been meaning to tell you that.
Yeah, I saw that, but I wouldn't go all the way over there just to see them. But it would have been cool to see what you thought, because I've seen them once when they opened up for Linkin Park, and it was spectacular.
Man, I am definitely going to do that. I got to one of these days just say, you know what? I need to start traveling now because I'm not always going to be able to travel.
Yeah.
There's also a band on that bill that you might want to go see, Chris, called Bloody Wood. Here we go. Here's headlines.
Oh, my.
Disney Plus.
You and Rosie saw them once.
Rosie, good news for you, by the way.
What's up? Bathroom.
Disney Plus will now let you see Daryl Hannah's naked butt in the movie Splash.
Oh, good. Finally.
Wait, what?
Yes.
Yeah, remember when she gets out of the water?
I know the scene.
Okay. Whoa. Oh, my God. Oh, hey. Oh, my God.
Thank you.
Hey, meat sauce.
John Candy
2016.
Was
calm down.
So, my gosh, I offended you so much.
You really offended me.
I feel like I need to take the knee.
For Brett and Zach's generation, Splash is a Tom Hanks movie in the 80s.
Right.
Where he basically starts dating a mermaid.
Right.
Well, when she gets out of the water, there's a scene where she turns human and then you can see her butt. Mm-hmm. Well, this is Disney Plus.
Right.
So they did some CGI stuff to kind of cover it up. But now that Disney Plus has a parental lock feature, they're saying, well, hey, if parents can lock it up,
right,
let's show that ass.
Show slime. Like,
come on. So it's now you can see Daryl Hannah's mermaid ass if you want to see it.
Deadpool's on Disney Plus now, so they're showing everything.
Very fair.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
32 years ago today.
It's a great hinder right there.
I know what you're going to say.
I know what you're going to say.
I don't know what's going on.
I saw the clip.
What?
Home Alone.
Yes.
It was released 32 years ago today.
Yeah, it's so good.
It is.
It's one of the best movies ever.
It's great.
It is great.
I love it. Man.
Hard not.
Daryl Hannah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I know. That's not her. That is a porn star, obviously. I can't help what my computer shows me.
Okay.
Even when I type in Daryl Hannah nude, it's not my fault. But, man, honestly, what a beautiful woman. And she still is beautiful, right? Have we moved on?
How about
Kill Bill? I'm still thinking of her.
Yeah, she was great in Kill Bill.
Oh,
she was
my
great
gosh. She had the one eyeball, right?
Yeah. And for a while.
Sauce and I were talking about this earlier, but Tarantino was on with our guy yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
With Stern. It was
incredible.
I love Quentin Tarantino. Yeah. Man.
Hard not to.
I would say turn the screen around, but I think the cameras will catch what's up.
Great point.
Yeah, I don't think
that
it'd be
can
good
be
idea.
Her, right? Because I can't imagine she likes that.
Oh my God.
Rosie, there's a new video game coming to Steam.
Coming to
where?
Wait, what?
Steam. It's like a.
I don't know what that is.
It's like an online.
It's like the app store for PC.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep. And the game lets you play as Jesus.
Sure does.
the Lord?
Or, I wonder how it ends.
Or one of those,
spoiler alert.
That's a good line. That's a good line. I am interested in this, honestly, because I read about that this morning, Corey, and I'm wondering if it's made by somebody, no offense, like you, or if it's made by somebody like who's a true believer. I wonder if it's a good game or an ironic game, if you know what I mean.
Right.
I don't really know, and I
my gut says ironic.
Whose interpretation is
just a reboot of Sims?
I think it might have been made by, like, the church. Like, you know, the Pope is a gamer himself, and
he might have, Pope is a gamer. He might have wanted to play Mortal Kombat as Jesus.
Oh man, that
maybe
would be,
guys, that Mortal Kombat.
Yeah. Maybe you guys saw these pictures or this story over the weekend. But a Chinese grandfather ran a marathon while chain smoking.
Yeah,
man, he finished with a respectable time of 3 hours, 28 minutes, and 45 seconds.
Get out of
here! And he chain smoked the whole way.
He was lighting heaters with heaters, which is the perfect way to smoke.
Did he have cowboy boots on, too? How cool is this guy?
I know.
3 hours.
What do you weigh, 110 pounds?
3.5 hours, chain smoking the whole time. Yeah. That guy's a machine.
My gosh. That's
machine.
Honestly, and there
he's
are
people. He's a Patrick Kane of
that guy can go,
There are people who do it much faster than that, but that is flying.
Dennis Savard.
That's 2 hours faster than I ever
Dennis Savard, not Patrick Kane.
Japanese convenience stores are going to start selling bottled water with hot water. Why? They are targeting people who want to be warmed up with a hot beverage but don't like coffee or tea.
Just hot water.
Hot water.
Who drinks hot water?
That's disgusting.
Yeah.
Ick.
I find that to be off-putting.
Matt, Zach and I should be off-putting.
Disney
Come
Plus.
On, that's funny.
I don't know what
it's a Zach Galifianakis line.
I don't remember it.
He in one of the bits, the behind the ferns thing, he says
I miss those.
He says to Jennifer Lawrence, that joke is off putting. And she says, you should be off putting.
Right, P U D D I N.
Oh, yeah. I see. Right. Like don't eat
like
pudding.
Eating, don't eat pudding.
Okay.
You know the kind of stuff that Bill Cosby never mind.
Oh, Rose.
Oh,
you made it weird.
Yeah. By the way, speaking of Cosby, I'm actually pissed when we had John Hamm on the podcast. Remember when we had a podcast?
Remember
that? The after-party podcast?
Like not really at all, actually.
Downloaded?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, boy.
Anyway, we had a podcast at one point. God, now I'm pissed.
Were you going to ask him something about?
No, we had John Hamm on, and I totally forgot this moment because I wish I would have asked him about it. There's something about watching somebody laugh as hard as you think that person can possibly laugh. And Zach Galifianakis did that to John Hamm. He was doing Between Two Ferns. I believe it was the outtakes, maybe even from the movie, the one that they did on Netflix.
Sure.
And Zach Galifianakis talks about John Hamm's character, Don Draper, and says Don Draper's, you know, suit and wardrobe's in the Smithsonian. And then he pauses and says, right next to the Cosby sweaters, and John Hamm is struggling to breathe. He's laughing so hard. Right where he's like, he got John so bad.
That's so good.
That's what a great line.
That's the best.
So, you know, it's fun when your friends laugh that hard, but you watch somebody that's famous just break because they can't believe how funny a line is. Man, that freaking blooper roll makes me laugh so hard.
That whole series was the best. I wish he'd do more of those.
I don't think he's done with it.
I hope not.
I don't think so either.
Would you guys do me a favor real quick? Are you done, Corey? Because I have something for you real quick.
The only one I wanted to bring up is just for you because I've never seen any of these movies. but the Disney Plus miniseries, The Santa Clauses, debuts today.
Yeah, I am.
I've seen none of those.
It's the latest, and it looks as if Santa, Tim Allen, he's not the real Santa Kids, is going to retire, and they need to find his replacement, and apparently they pick somebody who isn't quite qualified.
Gotcha.
That's what the storyline looks like. But it's a Christmas movie, and I'm excited about it because I am so worried about the Will Ferrell Christmas movie that is getting killed everywhere I read it.
It's 65% of Rotten Tomatoes.
Dude, it's so much better. That's so much better than it sounds like. Everybody, it's a musical.
Ugh.
I know. Ooh. I feel the same way. And I don't mind there being some music in a Christmas show.
70% on Rotten Tomatoes now.
Okay, well, good. I'm glad. Maybe people are... I'm going to watch it, of course. now, will you do me a favor, guys, please? You're all by your computers.
Right.
Do a search real quick for the 2024 Paris Olympic mascot. And take a look at it and see if it
and see what the
you can tell I'm a slow typer.
What is it?
It looks like
P-H-R-Y-G-E.
Yeah.
S.
People are saying that
meet Olympic.
You know the little man
in
the
pronounce
boat.
It. Yeah.
People are saying it's a little man in a boat.
Come on.
That's what they're saying. And if you look at it, now you'll never see anything else.
Oh my God. Oh, yes, you God. Are correct. Oh,
it's a little man in a boat Lord. With eyes.
Yeah. And little arms.
Yeah. And little arms. And he's wearing sneakers.
Yeah.
Oh,
dear
every
guy.
Place you look now, it's called the mm-hmm. that mascot.
Yeah. Oh.
And now I need to buy one.
Someone explain it. Someone explain it to Zach.
And man, there's a picture of a woman wearing a hat that has it on it.
Oh my.
And it couldn't look more like one of those.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Who approved that?
Larry Flynn.
Larry Flynn.
Yeah. All right, one final segment of the Power Trip Morning Show after this with Mark Rosen and Mark Parrish on the Fan.
Looking for holiday gifts that won't be re-gifted? Head to eBay Motors. With millions of parts and accessories at the right prices, there's something for every car lover on your list. And with the money you save, you can pick up something for yourself, too. Happy holidays indeed. ebaymotors.com. Let's ride.
In the land of 10,000 lakes, it's hard to imagine what's happening out west.
I hope and I pray for water.
And it's making some Minnesotans nervous about our water supply.
They can have all the snow they want in January, but not our groundwater.
Care 11 takes you to the nation's largest water reserve as it continues to drop.
Never, never did I think it would come to this.
And drop.
That's a lot of water missing.
See the dire conditions at the Hoover Dam. Water Wars, tonight at 10 on Care 11.
My husband and I really enjoy Chicago Wednesday on NBC.
Oh yeah, it's our special night.
First, we play Doctor with Chicago Med.
Dr. Halstead here. Mind if I take a closer look?
Then things get hot with Chicago Fire.
She's Stella, and I'm Severide.
And after that?
We go undercover with Chicago PD.
Detective Voight, am I under arrest?
You have the right to remain sexy.
Ooh, do the announcer voice.
Chicago Wednesday, tonight on NBC.
Woof!
It all starts tonight at 7, followed by Care 11 News at 10.
Treasure Island Resort and Casino, TICasino.com. You can go see Kathleen Madigan do stand-up this Saturday at TI. Tickets available at TICasino.com. She has been doing comedy for decades, and she's bringing her Midwest-inspired comedy tour, Do You Have Any Ranch, to TI this Saturday, November 19th. You can go see Kathleen by getting tickets now at TICasino.com. The Beach Boys are bringing their Tis the Season with the Beach Boys tour to Treasure Island Resort and Casino on Friday, December 16th. If you want to see them right before the holidays, you can do that at TICasino.com. And all the way till next summer, Saturday, August 19th, Jason Aldean is going to be at the Treasure Island Amphitheater outdoors. If you want to see some country music and see Jason Aldean, Saturday, August 19th, tickets available at TICasino.com. Maybe that's a really good idea for a Christmas present or something. If you have a Jason Aldean fan in your house, get it for him for Christmas, and then they can go see it next August. TICasino.com.
612, the bird.
Early Bird Electric is the trusted expert for all your home projects. With same-day and emergency service, you can trust Early Bird. Mention the Fan for a no-fee trip charge with repair purchase. Call
612, the bird. 612, the bird.
Yeah, you're right, Zach. Oh, I'm so sorry. Zach was just mentioning that it's winter outside. And he's right. It is winter outside. And it's going to get, whether it's like winter on the calendar or not, you know, that's not what I mean. I mean, it's cold and snowy. It's been snowing for 8 weeks, right? And do you walk around your house going, man, I should have gotten new windows. Hockey told me to go to Builders and Remodelers and I didn't do it. Don't worry. It's not too late. Get savings on top of savings with Builders and Remodelers Black Friday sales event. Scheduled before November 27th, and it's November 16th right now, so you'll get an extra 10% off already great deals on any project. You need windows? Well, buy one. Get half off your second highest rated Elements window, plus Black Friday savings of an additional 10% off. Does that sound like enough to get you to call? You should. Just go to buildersandremodelers.com for all the details. Builders and Remodelers. Nobody does it better. Nobody.
Hey, Meat Sauce, what's up?
I was helping a friend shop for a new car.
At Coon Rapids or Burnsville Nissan?
Neither.
What? I could have sworn you said neither. That can't be right.
Sorry, Doug, if it makes you feel any better. It was terrible. No selection. And to make things worse, I think that's because of the chip shortage. They've stooped to taking stuff off the cars.
Really? Like what?
Well, heated seats.
Who needs those in Minnesota?
Blind spot detectors.
Those can actually save your life.
Yeah, and apparently some new cars are only coming with one key.
Wow, that's a drawback if you're forgetful. At Walser Nissan in Burnsville and Coon Rapids, you don't have to worry about that. Our cars come with all of their parts, and what's even better, we've got hundreds of them. We have over 200 brand new Rogues and over 100 Pathfinders available for delivery in November. On top of that, qualified buyers can receive 36-month financing for 2.19%.
So what you're saying is I kind of screwed up.
Yes. Yes, you did.
Always go to Walser Nissan Burnsville and Walser Nissan Coon Rapids Nissan.
A gift of fine jewelry from Shane Company will be treasured forever.
You're listening live to The Power Trip on iHeartRadio and FM 100.3 KFAN, The Fan.
...847, final segment of The Power Trip Morning Show on a Wednesday with Mark Rosen. Mark Parrish, are you here on Friday, Perry?
Are you here on Friday?
Are you here on Friday, buddy?
Hey, what's up? What's up?
Yeah, are you here on Friday?
Yeah, I'm here on Friday.
Good. I want to make sure. It's been a while since we had all four, you know?
Yeah, no, I'm here. I'm here. I can't wait.
Normal game on Friday.
Yeah,
normal
let's go. Four. Mm. Let's go.
No Do Young Park, no ringer, just to come in here and wipe the floor with you guys.
Yeah, he's really smart.
This song wails.
It's core.
Yes, poor? Sir.
Can I read this real quick?
Go.
I don't know. It's a good question.
You can join Corey Cove and Meat Sauce this Thursday.
Stop.
You know what he's going to do.
Sauce.
What?
What's our bit this week?
Can I look at my calendar?
No.
We're at, with Coors Light.
Yes.
We're at the Bloomington Cowboy Jacks.
What's your confidence level?
100.
Zach, go.
Join Corey Cove and Meat Sauce this Thursday for Coors Light Hockey Night at Cowboy Jacks in Bloomington.
Hey! I'm so proud of you.
Thanks,
what
time, Daddy? Sauce? 7 to 9.
KFAN.com. Keyword hockey for more info.
Yeah.
Good for you,
boy. Saucy.
Good for you, Sasso.
Thanks, Daddy-O.
No, you're welcome. Mm-hmm. You're so welcome.
Yeah, it used to be me and Parrish. Now I'm stuck with Tenneby and Sauce.
Oh, boy.
Aw.
Yeah.
Aw.
Yeah, no.
Oh, I gotta do an NHL Network and Bally Sports North or whatever. Oh, God.
I do have to do way more work, though. I love the amount of work I had to do with you. That's true.
Right.
And reading seven questions.
Yes, that he figured out. I'll edit it.
Hey, Rozo?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any piece of sports memorabilia that's worth money? Not like something that you love, but something that's honestly worth money.
I guess the one thing that comes to mind is my ticket for the USA-Russian game in Lake Placid.
Okay.
I don't know what that's worth, but
it's definitely worth it.
I don't know. Gave us. I didn't have a media pass. They issued separate real tickets to each game we would go to. So I would have my media pass on around my neck, but then I would present the usher, whomever, the ticket. Well, I kept this one.
What kind of condition is it in?
Very good condition.
What do you keep it in?
None of your business.
No,
I mean, I keep it. It's in the program from the 1980 team. I have it in a separate little area.
Don't tell him where it's at. He's going to steal it. That's part of his bit.
John,
so put it in the vault.
John. It's fun looking at, you
it's
know.
It's going
to
be
more
valuable than that.
So all, you know, the players, you know, that are listed, their bios, you know, on the team, Irby and Patrick and the whole coaching staff, but I keep it in there. So that's probably the number one. I don't know what else. Mm. I mean, I have a bunch of baseballs that are signed and all that, but I honestly haven't kept as much. Not that much. I mean,
yeah.
Hey, Rosie.
Yeah.
Something called RR Auction. I just Googled what is a ticket to the Miracle on Ice worth?
Right.
Lake Placid 1980 Winter Olympic Miracle on Ice ticket, section 20, row F, seat 13.
Yeah, I don't know where.
This sell? This sold. I don't see a date here. No, here it is. The auction ended July 22nd of last year.
Okay.
Went for $1,099.
Oh, did it?
Damn.
Yeah.
So let's round up $1,100.
That's definitely probably the most expensive thing I have. Then I have baseball cards. Once in a while, I look them up. I've asked Marnie about it because her son, you know, is a huge collector. I said, ask your kid if this baseball card or basketball card's worth anything. Yeah, I used to have a bunch of them, so that would probably be it.
That's your prized possession?
I'd say so. I have a lot of memorabilia from Lake Placid. I kept pretty much all of it.
That's a good idea. One of Babe Ruth's baseball gloves is fetching the most money ever at auction. At last weekend's Louisville Slugger Museum and Factory Auction, an unidentified buyer shelled out just over $1.5 million for the mitt used by Ruth while he was still playing for the legendary 1927 Yankees. See, that's the kind of thing
that's the stuff
that I think is worth money.
Yeah, well, I actually kind of thought it would be worth more than that. I thought somebody, especially a Yankee fan out there, bucks would just spend.
Or David Wells. That's David
or
Wells.
David Wells. That's his thing.
Because he pitched once.
With his hat on.
Yeah, and he got... Fine, but he wore like an old Babe Ruth hat.
No kidding.
He pitched a perfect game against the Twins.
And he was hungover.
He was hungover. You're right, Sauce. Yeah.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Playing guilty.
Yeah. That's pretty neat, man. How about this, by the way? The glove was a gift from Babe Ruth to Jimmy Austin, who was an infielder with the St. Louis Browns.
Mm.
He just gave him his glove. I wonder, it's like the jersey swap at the end of the game.
Right.
Wow, that's pretty neat.
You never know what hits. Yeah. I mean, that's...
Yeah. Wow. A couple other things in sports. The Rams are losing their top wide receiver for at least four games. Cooper Kupp is on injured reserve.
Well, what a disaster of a season post-Super Bowl that's been for them.
I told Sauce that somebody needs to remind me, and I'm not going to go back and historically look if this is the case or not, because I think that it is mostly specifically for the team that loses. But whatever the over-unders are next year for the two teams that make it to the Super Bowl, I'm going to hammer the under.
Hmm. It never ends up well. Yeah. Rarely. I'm saying never. Rarely ends up well. Obviously had back-to-back champions. But
And there's going to be times you're going to lose that bet, but I'm going to have the Power Trip Bets approach to betting the Wolves under. I'm just going to bet the Super Bowl contenders unders every year and just see how it plays out.
Well, what was the over under for the Vikings win total?
I think
this
it was 8.5.
They're about there.
I have not looked this up either. I know since I won the Jets bet. I know the Jets were the first team this season to get over their over under because it was 5.5.
Yes, that's true. Jeez.
If the Vikings win, are they second?
My guess is
no one else has gotten over their over yet.
Can't be. I mean, look, even the Giants. I mean, I don't know what the Giants were. That'd be pretty close.
That's a good guess, though. That's probably in that 7-ish range, 8-9 range. That's a good guess. So the Vikings might be, if they can beat Dallas, the second or third team across the line.
Amazing.
Cash those tickets. Nothing like not even remotely sweating an over-under.
That's the best.
You cash your ticket. That's awesome.
It is.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
They mess up once in a while out there. Yeah.
And what I got, I can't imagine this is true, but he's just saying it to make everybody happy. Ron Rivera still deciding on who's going to be his quarterback for the Commanders.
Oh,
how do you not stick?
It's got to be Heinicke.
With Heinicke.
Yeah, but the one thing about this argument, they were talking about it on PTI last night, they're both bad.
What?
They're both. Heinicke is.
No, they're not great quarterbacks.
They're not. It's not like they're going to
bench the team.
He's better than Wentz.
Yeah, but that's
Wentz's record.
That's
awful,
not saying much.
No, but you go with the better quarterback.
Sure.
And you go with the quarterback who's been winning.
Right.
And the team's behind him.
Rallying around him.
It's a no-brainer.
It's a no-brainer.
I do too, but I'm just saying. Both of them aren't good.
I think Ron's just kind of playing with the media right now.
And it's for, you don't want to say to Wentz, you're obviously not.
Right.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
What a fall, man.
I don't. Oh man,
2017. He was the best quarterback in football.
Show's over. Sorry, guys. I had one more thing, and it involved the Bruins, but I can't get. I'm sorry.
We ain't got time for the Bruins.
Boston. Dang it.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I would have paid attention to that.
I know. I almost lost you there.
Pay attention on Friday because we need you to be competitive for initials.
Yes, please.
Ice cream's gonna be here.
Oh yes.
Sauce, your hands up.
The NFL Hall of Fame is putting the gloves and arm sleeve that Justin Jefferson caught that football with in camp.
Awesome.
Dang it.
That's really neat.
Kind of cool.
Good for you, Justin.
Tomorrow, no Ben Lieber, but slight upgrade to Carly Zucker.
Oh, nice. Okay.
I'm happy about that.
Okay.
T.O. will be here. Justin Ganzemius. We'll have a Kevin O'Connell press conference because we have access to him today.
Mm-hmm.
Lots to get to tomorrow. That's tomorrow, 5:30 to 9, but 9 to noon is next. See ya.
Keeps turning up here.
KFAN.